Welcome to CrossStreet Online. My name is Charlotte and I am so glad you've tuned in to watch today. I can't wait to share with you our true story. It's all about how Jesus gives freedom, as in He can rescue us and set us free. But before we get to that, let's first stand to our feet and worship Jesus together because He is definitely worthy of our praise.
I saw Satan fall like lightning. I saw darkness run for cover. But the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. I believe in signs and wonders. I have resurrection power. Yes, I do. Still the miracle that I just can't get over. My name is registered in heaven. Yeah, my praise belongs to You forever. Oh, this is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. Testimony. Come together, sons and daughters, bought with blood and washed in water. Sing the praises of the Spirit, Son and Father. Our God will finish what He started. Yes, our God will finish what He started. Oh, this is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony.
From there.
This song has been on repeat here in my home. I just love that song. And now it's time for us to learn our memory verse. This one is found in Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. I'm going to say it in the New Living Translation, and it says it this way. But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against these things. This reminds me of one of my favorite songs. So we're going to do one more song together, but this one has lots of motions. So give yourself plenty of space. Here we go. Love that song. I think of that song every time I hear Galatians 5, 22 and 23. Every time. Now remember to share a video of you saying your verse and have mom or dad upload it onto Facebook and tag PV CrossStreet. If you want to do yourself doing the song, I would love to see that too. So today we're going to hear a great rescue story Everybody loves a rescue story. I remember a great one from when I was in high school. There was this little girl named Jessica who lived in Texas, and she fell down a well. She was only a year and a half, and she fell down a well that was 22 feet deep. They had no idea how to get her out. The whole country was praying for baby Jessica, and first responders worked around the clock to get her out. They could hear her down there, but they didn't know how to reach her because the hole was so small. So the whole country was praying, and they were gathered around their TV sets. 2 whole days passed, and they were trying everything they could to reach her. And then, well, just watch this.
Right, but they are both coming up out of the well at the same time. You can see it moving. Both the rope and the cable are coming up at the same inch per foot at the same time.
Rodney, I think I'm hearing the crowd react
yes,
back there, too,
the
as
crowd.
Well.
Yes. It's getting louder.
We've got her.
Got
We're getting the indication.
Yeah.
We're getting the indication. People are seeing it.
Thank God.
Thank God
We're seeing
for
it.
This.
There she is.
There she is.
There she is, and she, her eyes are open.
Jessica.
You can
oh
see her eyes
God.
Open.
Oh.
Bless her
She's
heart.
Blinking.
Bless her heart.
She's blinking.
58 hours, exactly. Thank God.
58 hours.
Wasn't that a great story? I told you, everybody loves a good rescue story. And although that was a pretty good one, I've got another great one for you from the Bible. You can find this story in the book of Acts, chapter 12. Now, during this time in history, Christians were being persecuted. Many were thrown in jail, and many died for having faith in Jesus. And there was a man by the name of King Herod Agrippa. He was arresting Christians, and his name might sound familiar to you because there were several King Herods mentioned in the Bible. It all started with his grandfather, King Herod the Great. You'll know him because of the Christmas story. He was the one who tried to fool the wise men into telling them where the baby Jesus was so that he could kill him. Bad guy. Okay. And then his uncle was King Herod Antipas. He's the one who beheaded John the Baptist. Bad guy, okay? And this King Herod Agrippa was turning out just like them. He had already put to death James the Apostle, and now he arrested Peter. This story takes place when Peter was in prison, and the night before King Herod was going to put him on trial, King Herod was going to have him killed. And just look what God did.
Slapstick theater. Peter escapes from prison. This is Peter.
Hey-o!
Who was one of Jesus' disciples.
Yep.
Peter told people about Jesus. There was a king named Herod who tried to stop anyone who tried to tell others about Jesus. He arrested Peter and took him to jail to be executed. While Peter was in prison, the people of the church prayed for him. The night before Peter was supposed to go to trial, he was sleeping. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord stood before him. The angel woke Peter up and said, "Quick, get up." The chains fell off Peter's wrists.
Whoa!
Then the angel told him to get up and get ready to go and to follow him. So Peter left the cell, but all the time he thought was happening wasn't real and that it was just a vision. They passed by the guards, and when they came to the iron gate, it opened for them on its own.
Wow, awesome!
They were walking through the street when the angel suddenly left him.
Wait, what just happened?
Peter finally realized that this was all really happening and that God had sent an angel to save him from what King Herod and the Jewish leaders had planned to do to him.
Wow!
he went to the home of Mary, where many believers were together praying. When Peter knocked at the door, a servant girl came to answer.
Hey, let me in! Peter!
When she realized it was Peter, she was so excited that she ran inside to tell people instead of letting Peter in.
I'm so honored.
It's Peter!
The people inside thought the girl was wrong and said, it must be Peter's angel. But Peter kept knocking. When the people finally opened the door, they were amazed. Peter told them about what happened and all about how God sent an angel to rescue him from prison.
Wow. Peter must have thought it was over for him that night. But the church was praying and God decided to show up in an amazing way. That angel appeared at the right moment and Peter's chains fell off and that prison door was flung open. Now, Peter had been set free by God. Now, you may not be stuck in a prison or even in a deep well somewhere, but you might have things that are holding you down or hurting you. Some things that keep us prisoner are bad choices or bad feelings and attitudes or bad things that happen to us. Jesus can rescue you from that. I was a prisoner to my sin and there was nothing I could do to escape on my own. And then Jesus came into my life. I gave my life to him and he set me free. I'm free from the power of sin. Now that doesn't mean that I don't sin anymore, but it does mean that I have his Holy Spirit inside me to help me say no to sin. And I am now free from the penalty of sin. I love how God can set us free. He can break the physical chains like the ones that were holding Peter, or he can break the emotional and invisible chains that are keeping us captive. God can give you freedom too. He can help you face whatever is weighing you down, and he can help you overcome anything you're tempted by or afraid of. God is powerful, and he can help you overcome anything. Every Christian has a rescue story to tell. And when we're back together at CrossStreet, you should ask your small group leader what their rescue story is. And until then, here are some familiar faces to say hi.
Hey guys, it's Miss Shannon. I am coming to you from my backyard right now. It is nice and it is sunny and we are outside enjoying the day. I hope that all of you are doing so well. I miss seeing you and high-fiving you and hugging you. I miss teaching you in large group. But I wanted to say hi. I wanted to let you all know that I can't wait until we are all back together again. Love you guys. Miss you guys. Bye.
Hey, CrossStreet kids. This is Kevin coming to you straight from my backyard. I hope you guys are having a great time. Hopefully outside today a little bit, and hope you're taking advantage of those scavenger hunts that we're having. Kids enjoyed that yesterday, but hope you're doing well with your family, and we miss you guys, we love you, and we pray that you can be together soon. So take care, God bless you guys, bye.
Hello, this is Heather with CrossStreet K-2. Just wanted to make sure that everybody's doing great, trying to enjoy family time, trying to enjoy the new normal. We miss you guys. Can't wait to get back to church. Love you guys. Hope all is well. Bye.
Hi, everyone. I'm Miss Renee. Hey, I just wanted to say hello and let you all know that I miss you, and I hope you're all doing well. I'm praying that we're all going to be back together soon, and I know that we will, and we're going to have so much fun. And I hope you're having a good time with your families while you're at home. You guys, take care, and we'll see you soon.
Hey, friends. Hope you guys are doing well during this, and we're praying that you and your family are staying safe and healthy. We miss you a lot.
We think about you every Sunday, and we've been praying for you, and we just hope that you're having a good time with your family at home and that you all stay healthy and happy.
Hello friends, it's Miss Dawn. Oh my goodness, we miss you all so much. We cannot wait till we can be together again real soon so we can worship and sing. And we pray that all of you are doing really well during this time. And we want you to know that we're sending you virtual fist bumps, and we can't wait to be with you again. See you soon.
Hey, BB Crusty friends. Just wanted to say hi. It's been a while since we last saw each other, so I just wanted to update you guys on what's been going on with this whole virus. Everything's going good. I'm just staying home, away from everybody. Hope you guys are doing well. I hope to see you guys when we return. Take care. Bye.
Hey everyone, it's Miss Rachel. I miss you all lots, and I hope you're taking care of yourselves and staying healthy. I also hope that you're somehow staying entertained, whether that's playing board games with your family or learning or creating something new. For me, I've been learning a lot of new songs on my ukulele, as well as doing some dancing on Just Dance, which I'm not a good dancer. Anyways, I hope you all are doing well, and know that I'm praying for you, and I can't wait till we're all back together again at church.
Hi guys, this is Linda. I miss you guys. I miss seeing your sweet faces every Sunday and getting to talk to you and be with you and talk about the Bible with you and hear your prayer requests. I hope you all are doing well and enjoying your time spent in your house with your family. I can't wait to see you guys again soon. Much love to you all.
Hi friends, we just wanted to say hi. We hope you're having a good time enjoying something and finding something fun to do. We sure miss you and can't wait till we get to see you again at church and worship Jesus together. Love you and miss you. See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
I love the time we got to spend together today. And before we say goodbye, don't forget about your memory verse or your creative challenge. Make sure that you post those on Facebook and tag PV CrossStreet. I hope to see some amazing rescue stories this week. Here are the creative challenges from last week. And if you forget how to do the creative challenge, stick around for the instruction video. Until next week, bye.
I'm Riley with CrossStreet. In the upcoming weeks of our worship... Hey, this is Riley with CrossStreet. In our upcoming weeks of online worship, we wanted to find a way to include you guys to show us what you learned. Each week we'll issue a creative challenge. The only rule is you have to be creative. You can use a favorite hobby or game to show us your favorite moment in the story. You could use things like Play-Doh, Legos, or even draw. You can also use a game. You could use games like Minecraft, Roblox, or Gotcha. You can even create a diorama. And you can also act out a scene of your favorite moment in the story with your family. Dad, what's a diorama?
Thanks, Riley. This is Brian Austin from CrossStreet. Once you finish your creation, you can have your family take a picture or maybe shoot a video and be able to upload it to the CrossStreet Parents Facebook group. They could also choose to email it to your CrossStreet leader's email address, but also make sure that they include your name and submission. Each week, we are going to showcase a few of your creations online during the live segment at the end of our broadcast. So please tune in every week for a chance to be able to see your creations online. Thanks, and we'll see you next week.